Amazon Recognition is a powerful visual analysis service that can detect objects in images and videos, and I'm going to add this to my home assistant. Hello, Kirill Poyatsky is here. At the end of this video, you will be able to send images from your camera's Aretin Home Assistant to Amazon Recognition Service, and you will receive back information what exactly is detected on these images. Then you can use Home Assistant automation and scripts to send emails, Telegram messages, and any other notification service that you might have. If the camera image contains persons, for example, and it doesn't matter what model or brand your camera is, you can use it if your camera is already working with Home Assistant. And I have some good and bad news for you. The bad news is that the Amazon Recognition service can cost you around $1 per 1000 processed images. But the good news is that you can get started at no cost. The free trial lasts 12 months and allows you to analyze 5000 images per month. Now, let's go!
Click on Home Assistant Community Store, or also known as HAX. Then click on Integrations and...
Hey there! We are using Home Assistant Community Store again. If you still don't have it, you can watch this video first and then come back here.
Search for Recognition, Amazon Recognition. Click on it and then click on Install button. This is a short documentation how to use this integration. I'll open the repository as well.
We're going to sign up for Amazon Web Services free trial now, as this is required for our mini Home Assistant project.
I'll quickly show you how to create an Amazon Web Service account. Go to portal.aws.amazon.com. This is what the page looks like. You have to enter your email, password, choose a strong password here, and AWS account name. Click continue. Here you can choose personal account and postal code and the city, the whole address of yours. On the next step, you have to enter your credit card. Don't worry, they need this to check if everything is okay. I think they will charge you $1 and then they will return it back, and they will not charge you for anything else for the next 12 months. On the next step, you have to enter your phone again and security check code. You will receive a verification code on your phone that you have to enter here. Click verify code and you're done. Choose basic plan here because it's free, unless you want to pay something to Amazon, and that's it.
Services in AWS, such as Amazon Recognition, require that you provide credentials to access them. I'm going to use Amazon Web Services Identity and Access Management to create a user.
Open the Identity and Access Management console, click on Create Individual Users, Manage Users, and then Add User. Choose your username here and select Programmatic Access Type. Click Next. Click on Attach Existing Policies and search for Recognition with K here. You should find Amazon Recognition Full Access. Select this and click Next. This is optional, you can skip this and create user. This is what we need: access key ID and secret access key. Copy these credentials because we will need them for Home Assistant.
Okay, that was easy. We have everything we need from Amazon. Now let's put these credentials in Home Assistant configuration.
And the next thing before I restart my Home Assistant is to add the configuration in my configuration.yaml file. I'll click on File Editor and I'll open the configuration.yaml file, and then I'll just paste this config that I have, and then I'll explain you a little bit what is exactly doing. Basically, it's adding this platform Amazon Recognition, and here we can paste our Amazon Access Key ID and Amazon Secret Access Key. You have two options, either to type them directly here or to link them exactly as I did here. Here you can choose a region. I chose Ireland because it's closer to my place. And this is the save folder where the images will be saved. Images from this entity, when they are processed, they will be saved in this TMP folder. This is optional as it is written here, but we will need this later. This is also optional. Confidence 90%. By default is 80. You can type whatever you want here. This means if the confidence for the detected object is more than 90%, draw a box around the object and put a label and a score there. And this is our source. Basically, this is this camera entity ID that I described here. Here you can type your own entities for your existing cameras in your Home Assistant. So you can use it for image processing and object detection. So that's it. I'll click save. And then I'm going to restart the Home Assistant from server controls. Check configuration as always. Configuration valid, and then restart. I will fast forward it in order not to waste your time.
I have a quick question. Is it okay for you to send pictures to Amazon Recognition Service? Or this violates your privacy and you prefer not to do it? Let me know what do you think in the comment section below.
Okay, the Home Assistant is now restarted. To check if everything is okay, go to Developer Tools and then on States and search for Image. Here it is. Image Processing Recognition Person. Whatever. To check if it's really working, go to Services and search again for this image processing scan. Choose your entity here and then click Call Service. Now if I return back here. Here it is. Here is the result. Person. There is a person detected on the camera image, because the camera is pointing at me, and this state means that one person is detected. If the state is zero, that means that no person is detected at all. We will use this state later in our automations. If this is two or more, that means two or more persons are detected on the image. The other parameters are we detect that the person is man and it's indoors. Curtain, there is curtain here, yes. Very good. Let me try to show you my real image. Maybe if I add a card here, it will be better. Picture entity. And I'll choose camera entity. Here it is. Hello. Okay. As you can see, the camera is looking at a man with curtain in the background. So it detects everything correctly.
Let's try to create Home Assistant automation using Amazon Recognition Service.
I will try to add a very simple but very useful automation now. I will use my kitchen lights as a trigger, because I don't have motion sensor, but you can easily change this with motion sensor afterwards, you see. So my automation will be the following. If I turn on the kitchen lights, start image processing from the Sonoff camera that I have here. If person is detected on the image, then send a notification to Telegram containing that image. If no person is detected from the camera, nothing happens. So you can use this automation with, instead of the kitchen lights, you can use motion sensor. So let's start. I'll click on configuration. No, I'll click on file editor. I prefer this way. And I'll open my automation.yaml file. here it is. It's empty. Do I have to delete this? I don't know. This is my automation. I'll copy this automation first and I'll paste it here. Basically, this is an ID that should be unique, alias, to understand in simple words what this automation do. A trigger, which is from platform state, and the trigger is if the kitchen lights goes to on, and the action is call this image processing.scan with this entity ID. You can get this entity ID from the developer tools. Here it is. Here it is, the entity ID. Yours will be probably different. For sure it will be different. So copy this and where was I? Here. And paste it here. So you have to change this one and your trigger. The best trigger will be motion sensor here, but I don't have one, so I'll use my kitchen lights for a trigger. And I'll click save. Then I'll go to configuration, server control, and I'll check my config. Config is valid, and then I'll reload my automation. Where it is? Here it is, actually. I think we are ready. Now, if I go to my dashboard of Home Assistant, and if I turn on my kitchen lights, and then I'll go to developer tools, I want to refresh this, image recognition, 2324, yes, the event is triggered. Let me turn around the camera a bit in order not to see me, to show you how the state of this sensor, this entity, will become zero. That means zero persons are detected. If I turn my camera a bit in order not to be in the camera side, and I'll turn off and turn on the kitchen again, I'll trigger another image scan processing, and this time if I go to developer tools, I'll click refresh again, I'll search for image recognition, and this time the state is zero. That means zero persons are detected in the image, which is absolutely correct.
Hey, I bet that you can smash the like button faster than Amazon recognition response. Try it out and let me know who won this.
So let's continue with our automation. I'll add another one. Sorry for this. I'll add this automation that will do the following. Let's paste it and I'll explain. I'll go to file editor again and I'll paste it just below the first one. I will quickly explain what this automation do. This is the trigger of the automation, which monitors the state of this entity ID. Remember, the same ID here. And if the state of this entity ID is above zero, then execute this action below. If the state is more than zero, that means more than zero persons are detected on the scanned image by Amazon recognition. If it's zero, there are no person in the image. And the action is pretty simple. It used the service notify telegram to send this message, person is detected, and this photo. This is the scanned photo and it's stored in TMP folder. If you remember where it is, let me show you quickly. If I open again a configuration.yaml file, where it is, configuration.yaml, here it is. If you remember, here is the save file folder path. So here, inside this folder, the following file will be saved. And I'll grab this file and attach it to the Telegram message. If everything is working okay, I'll click save. Then I'll go to configuration, server controls again, check configuration, valid, and then I'll reload automations.
Hey, if you are new here, consider subscribing. Now let's go back.
Now it's time to test this. I'll go again to my Home Assistant dashboard. Here it is. There is no person on the picture on the camera side right now, so I'll disable my kitchen lights and I'll enable it. This will scan this image. As you can see from here, but no, the state is zero. That means that no person is detected. Now, if I turn back the camera towards me, here it is, and I will turn off the lights again and then turn them on, I will receive a picture. And here is my picture. Person. 99% confidence. Very good. It's working.
Any sort of engagement on this channel does really help a lot with the YouTube algorithm. So you make sure that you hit the subscribe, like and bell buttons if you enjoyed this video. Also, feel free to add me on Twitter by searching for this username. I'm trying to post there frequently. I really hope that you find this information useful and you now know how to send your camera images from Home Assistant to Amazon Recognition Service for analysis. Thank you for watching, stay safe and see you next time!